Well, if you're searching for a new job or even applying to colleges, this is the time to get a head start on spring cleaning your social media. What you post online can have some serious consequences. Here to break it all down is etiquette expert Akilah Easter. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
This is a big deal because we've seen a lot of tragic situations with people on their social media.
And I think people are just thinking it's celebrities, but people are losing college scholarships because of what they're posting on social media. Pretty much a job interview, they can find everything that they cannot legally ask you on your social media platform.
Okay, let's get to that, because not only are you an expert, but you're also a college professor, so I feel like you're the perfect person to talk to about this. So you've heard stories of students actually losing their scholarships because of their posts on social media. What are you seeing these days?
More and more students are feeling the freedom that they have allowed with social media, and they're not thinking about the long-term consequences. There have been athletes who have lost their scholarship because of certain things that they showed themselves drinking and those different types of things on social media. Those little 10-second snippets can ruin your future.
Yeah, and then everyone thinks that, oh, well, it's going to get deleted, so it won't live.
Oh,
it won't always be there.
You know those screenshots.
Snapchat and the InstaChat thing that goes on.
They're not thinking of the long-term consequences, and at that age, you're really not thinking about it. And even adults aren't thinking about those consequences.
So you're saying people are getting accepted to college, they're getting scholarships, and then even losing it. They'll go and take your stuff away.
You have responsibilities when you have a scholarship. So I was an athlete. Wow. We had specific things that we could and could not do. We didn't have social media then, but I can imagine what new rules the NCAA or new scholarship rules that are in effect.
Things are different.
Right.
All right, well, how does social media affect your job search? Let's talk about after college.
Now, my clients, I come in and prepare them for their jobs. I tell them to deactivate their accounts.
Really?
But there is one thing. I would keep one social media platform, your clean one. I would keep one out there, because sometimes when people are looking, when they don't see that you have social media, that's a little suspect even nowadays.
I think it is a little weird these days when I hear people say they don't have social media, because then I'm like, well, maybe you're not connected to the world.
Yeah, you're not social, different types of things.
You're not social, but also there's so much information and news on social media that you're missing out on when you're not on it.
Yeah, so if you have three accounts, I would say deactivate two of them and clean up. Go back to 1998 and clean up all of those different tweets. We've had, we've seen celebrities get in trouble for things that were 5-10 years ago.
Mm.
Yeah.
When you say deactivate, do you think I can still make it private?
No. See, people do that because, you know, a friend of a friend of a friend could know that person who's searching for your information. I'm not going to tell you my stalking tricks, but but you can always know somebody. Yes.
From someone that works at a college and someone that's also hired people, she's giving you guys the 411.
You have to be aware of this. Understanding that there is bias when people are hiring you, no matter how much you try to get away from it, this is where they can see everything about you. If they don't like something, it could be right there on your social media.
So what do you recommend to college students as well as job seekers? What do you specifically recommend them to do?
I tell them to get rid of the wild pictures. I even tell people to take pictures when you're holding alcohol in your hand, because even though it could be months apart from each other, it still looks like you have a lot of pictures with alcohol in your hand. So being aware of those different types of things. Do a deep clean. Have your parents go through and see, do you think that this is kosher? Do you think that this is okay? Because a child's perspective is not always the same as an adult's perspective.
Yeah.
And then those who are job applicants, I would make sure you take off things such as you're recently married, your pregnancy announcements. All of those different things are things that they cannot ask you, and that would be blatant on your social media.
Mm, I actually lost an opportunity like that. The person before me, it was for a sports position, and the person before me, they ended up leaving the job early because they were planning a wedding and it got so stressful. And when they heard I was engaged and planning a wedding, I could see the moment that the interviewer, energy switched.
Oh,
and they were like, oh, you're engaged?
Ugh.
You're getting married? Because someone walked up who knew me. They said, oh, how's the wedding planning going? And
they don't think that you're going to be dedicated. They think that you may be starting a family. All of those different things come into play.
Yeah.
Once you made it to the job interview, you have the qualities. Everybody has the qualifications.
And it could have been something else. However, I know that that did not help. I literally saw the interviewers,
their
mood
face
change.
Yeah.
And you don't think about that because you don't feel like, you feel like this is 2019 and that
you're just
we've
being
gotten
you.
Past discriminatory practices.
Right.
But like you said, human bias, it's just being
natural.
Human.
Right. Political affiliations, religion. religion, sexual orientation, all of those things are on your social media. And that's a quick thing that they can Google search real quick and they know everything about you.
Yeah, very good point. Akilah, thank you.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate
it. Reminding everyone to think twice before you post. And make sure you follow Akilah on her social media and her website, akilahciti.com.